Hello guys, this is Leo the Wise, giving to all men, their needed uprise.
Find the part 3 of the video titled The Sexodus, The Men Giving Up on Women and Checking Out of Society. Author Milo Yiannopoulos, published originally by Breitbart.com. Sexual dysfunction is not unique to the 21st century nor, certainly, to the West. Japan herbivores men who shun sex and prefer saving money and going on long walks to riding motorcycles and flirting with girls have been well documented and are regarded by social scientists as the best example of male sexuality turning in on itself. But although the Sexodus, a new retreat into solitude by Western males, has a different flavor to it and dramatically different ideology from previously observed social crises, many characteristics are identical. And what's troubling about men throwing in the towel in both East and West is the rapidity with which the malaise is spreading across entire generations, fueled not just by sexual dissatisfaction but also the economic and educational pressures felt by so many young boys. Perhaps we shouldn't be surprised. It little wonder that in the disorientating modern world, men should seek out extreme measures to help them relate to, and get what they want from, the opposite sex. That probably explains the rise of Julian Blank, who claims his seminars can transform the way women will respond to you. Blank is at the extreme end of a movement known as pickup artists or PUAs. But other voices in the PUA or red pill movements, including Daria Shvalazadeh, who goes by the pen name Rush V, says there are structural reasons why society is evolving away from intergender contentment. Part of the problem is unrealistic female expectations, says Volazade. Getting laid with attractive women has become extremely hard for average men. Women today of average or even below average quality desire an elite man with above average looks, muscles, intelligence, and confidence. If an average girl works hard enough, she will be able to have a one-night stand with a hot guy every now and then because he happened to be horny and wanted an easy lay. The girl then thinks that she actually can get such a man to commit to her for the long term, and so does and give the average guys a chance, holding out for the type of stud that she had a brief sexual encounter with in the past. Volazadeh has some controversial views on the state of modern womanhood, too. He says, it also damaging that the attractiveness of women is rapidly declining, mainly due to the obesity epidemic. No matter what members of the ad acceptance movement say, men have an innate need for fit women. What happens is the few attractive girls left get unimaginable amounts of attention. According to Volazadeh, today sexual marketplace represents a Pareto distribution in which 20% of the top guys have access to 80% of the best women, which has the effect of leaving women holding out for the perfect man, a man who of course never comes. Volazadeh agrees with masculinity author Jack Donovan that men have been feminized by a culture that rejects and ridicules male characteristics and habits. Good luck naming one male role model that men have today that actually helps them become men, he remarks. These thoughts are echoed on occasionally rude but compelling male-oriented blogs, such as the phenomenally popular Chateau Hardest. They are also supported by the current state of the sex wars, which are constituted bizarrely. One of the remarkable things about recent high-profile skirmishes with feminists is how few mainstream heterosexual men have been involved. In the Gamergate video games controversy, opposition to social justice warriors and their attempts at censorship on Twitter has come from older gay men in public life and younger geeks, gamers and dropouts. In the case of Matt Taylor, it was geeks and other women. Straight young men simply don't want to know anymore. They e not getting involved. Some women, too, horrified by what lesbianized third-wave feminism claims to do in their name, opt out of the argument. The absurd result is that geeks, queers and dykes are dominating the discussion about how men and women should interact. Jack Donovan, for example, is gay, as is your present correspondent. It is if gays are the only men left prepared to fight masculinity corner. Men want normal relationships that include sex, says Volazadeh. Some of them will read pickup artist books or go to seminars by people such as Rushvi if they don't get it or need to be trained out of white knight behaviors instilled in them by a female-dominated culture. Men have been taught that being a nice guy gets you laid. DOESN. What strikes a lot of women as strange is how rational and systematic so much of this decision-making is by men. Many young men literally perform a cost-benefit analysis and decide that women aren't worth the hassle. Girls who lose out on this scenario. Men don't need the sustained emotional intimacy that comes with a fulfilling sexual relationship and can retreat into masturbatory pursuits. Prostitution and one night stands much more comfortably. But that exactly what it is, from a male point of view, a rational opting out from education, work and marriage by men who have had enough. As a remarkable book by Dr. Helen Smith called Men on Strike warned in July last year, the consensus on this stuff is growing rapidly. Men, driven, as many of them like to say, by fact and not emotion, can see that society is not fair to them and more dangerous for them. They point to the fact that they are more likely to be murder victims and more likely to commit suicide. Women do not choose to serve in the armed forces and they experience fewer deaths and injuries in the line of work generally. Women get shorter custodial sentences for the same crimes. There are more scholarships available to them in college. They receive better and cheaper health care, and can pick from favorable insurance packages available only to girls. When it comes to children, women are presumed to be the primary caregiver and given preferential treatment by the courts. They have more, better contraceptive options. Women are less likely to be homeless, unemployed or to abuse drugs than men. They are less likely to be depressed or to suffer from mental illness. There is less pressure on them to achieve financial success. They are less likely to live in poverty. They are given priority by emergency and medical services. Some might call these statistical trends female privilege. Yet everywhere and at all times, say men rights advocates, the lived experiences and perceived oppression of women is given 100% of the airtime, in defiance of the reality that women haven't just achieved parity with men but have overtaken them in almost every conceivable respect. What inequalities remain are the result of women choices, say respectable feminist academics such as Christina Hoff Sommers, not structural biases. And yet men are constantly beaten up over bizarre invented concepts such as rape culture and patriarchal privilege. The bizarre but inevitable conclusion of all this is that women are fueling their own unhappiness by driving men to consider them as sex objects and nothing more, because the thought of engaging in a relationship with a woman is horrifying or too exhausting to contemplate. And the sexodus will affect women disproportionately harshly because research data show that when women act like men by having lots of casual sex, they become unhappy, are more likely to suffer from depression and destroy their chances of securing a meaningful long-term relationship.
And that is it for now. If this content was entertaining and interested you, please share, like, and subscribe to this channel. I am the Swan, leading men till dawn, and even beyond. Thanks for the audience.